Thank you very much. So, hello everyone. I'm Elena Agostini, and I'm a PhD of the University of Rome. Okay.
There we go.
Okay. Okay. As he said, I'm going to talk about BitCracker, that is my BitLocker password cracker on GPU. So, let's start with a cat. And then, what is BitLocker? Just to give you an overview about this tool. BitLocker, as you can see, is an encryption feature introduced in the latest version of Windows, I think since Windows Vista. And it is able to encrypt any type of memory units, removable or not, like USB, pen drive, hard disk, and so on. And the user can use different type of authentication methods to encrypt or and also to decrypt its memory unit. Just for example, a user can use a password, a smart card, or recovery key, and a lot of other different methods. Okay, this is just an example of how BitLocker works. As you can see, here we are on a Windows 7 Enterprise Edition, and I plugged in my USB pen drive, that's Kingston, and I want to encrypt my pen drive. So with the right click, I choose to turn on BitLocker. And then BitLocker asked me if I want to encrypt my pen drive with a password or with a smart card. And I choose the password way, so I type the password. And then BitLocker starts to encrypt my device. So if I want to read the content of my encrypted device, I must type the same password I use for the encryption. And BitLocker so is able to decrypt the content of my device, and I can read or write my files. So how does it work? During the encryption procedure, BitLocker uses two different types of encryption key. The first key is called the full volume encryption key that is used by BitLocker to encrypt the sector of the memory device. And the key is stored in the encrypted disk, in the encrypted memory unit. And the key is encrypted in turn with the volume master key, that is the main key used by BitLocker that encrypts the entire volume. Finally, the volume master key is encrypted in turn with the authentication method chosen by the user. So in my example, the method was the password. So, as I said, when a user wants to read the content of his encrypted pen drive or memory unit or disk, whatever, the user must choose one of the authentication methods. And depending on this choose, BitLocker uses a different decryption algorithm to decrypt the volume master key. Then in turn, BitLocker, with the decrypted volume master key, decrypt the full volume encryption key. And finally, decrypt the entire memory unit. During this talk, I'm going to focus on the user password authentication method and on the decryption algorithm used by BitLocker to decrypt the volume master key, because as you can see, if you're able to decrypt the right volume master key, you're also able to decrypt the right memory unit. So this is the algorithm used by BitLocker to decrypt your memory device. So the user types the password, then BitLocker applies twice the SHA function, and then it starts the main loop of more than 1 million of iteration. During each iteration, the BitLocker hash a particular structure that I'm going to show you in the next slides. And then after this main loop, it produced an intermediate key. With this key, BitLocker encrypts the IVU obtained from the nonce using IS. And with encrypted IVU, BitLocker decrypts the MAC and the volume master key. Finally, to be sure that the input password was the right password, is the right password, BitLocker compute the MAC value starting from the decrypted volume master key value, and then it makes a comparison between the two MAC values. If they are the same, so the input password was the right password. Okay, if we want to attack this algorithm, we need some improvement. The first one is about the final part of the algorithm, because we can do it better. We can avoid this comparison of the Mac, saving a lot of operation. How we can do that? We can avoid the comparison looking at the standard of BitLocker. Because the standard of BitLocker says that in an encrypted memory unit, we can find the salt, the nonce used by BitLocker to obtain the IBU, and also the encrypted value master key and the encrypted MAC value. Moreover, BitLocker says that the structure of the decrypted value master key is a structure of 44 bytes. And the first 12 bytes hold information about the key itself. So the first 2 bytes are the size of the value master key that, as I said, is always 44 bytes. And then the byte 8 and 9 represents the type of encryption. And according to the standard, BitLocker has only 5 different types of encryption. Finally, the remaining 32 bytes are the key itself. So this is the structure of a decrypted volume master key. So having this information, we can improve the previous algorithm in this way. So when we obtain the decrypted volume master key, it's not necessary to make the comparison of the MAC value, because if the values of the byte 0, 1, 8, and 9 of the decrypted volume master key are compliant with the BitLocker standard, then we are quite sure that the input password was the right password. This is an empirical result, but until now, I made a lot of tests using different types of Windows, 7, 8, 8.1, and I never have any type of false positive, so I think that it's a good improvement. Okay, now I'm going to talk about BitCracker. That, as I said, is a password cracker for BitLocker. And so the aim of BitCracker is to find the right user password used to encrypt a memory device that we want to encrypt without knowing the password. Also, another aim of my research is to provide further details about the BitLocker standard, how the encryption and decryption procedure works, and so on. And so to find the right password, BitCracker perform a dictionary attack using GPUs. That is, BitCracker is a mono GPU algorithm that I've written in CUDA-C, and that it is able to perform the BitLocker decryption algorithm improved, as we saw in the previous slide. And to perform this attack, BitCracker needs a really fast SHA-256 hash implementation, because it's the most used function during the entire algorithm. So this is the decryption algorithm of BitCracker. As BitLocker, BitCracker applies twice the SHA function to the input password. Then it creates a structure. That is a particular structure of 128 bytes that we can divide into block of 64 bytes. In the first part, we find the previous hash field and the first hash field, that are 2 hash fields that contains the value of the first hash contains the value of the first application of the SHA function to the input password. And the previous hash will be used during the main loop and will have the value of the previous hash of the previous iteration. Then the second part of the structure is another block of 64 bytes. We can find inside the salt a counter and the padding and the size message that are here to be compliant with the standard of the SHA, standard. Then, having this structure, BitCracker starts the main loop of more than 1 million iterations, so it's a very big loop, and it applies the SHA function to the first part and then to the second part of the input structure. Having the hash of the current iteration, BitCracker updates the previous hash field in the first part, and then it increments the counter on the second part. So basically, the value of the counter is the number of the current iteration. As I explained before, BitCracker decrypts the value master key, having this information, and then check the values of the value master key. If they're compliant with the standard, the input password was the right password. Looking at this algorithm, we can say that the bottleneck of the algorithm is the main loop, because if for each password, BitCracker must perform more than 1 million of iteration, this means that for each password, BitCracker must perform more than 2 million of SHA function. So it's very important to perform each iteration as fast as possible and save as much arithmetical operation as possible. So for this reason, I've introduced a second improvement that is concerning the second part of the input structure. Because we can make some prevision about the values of those fields during each iteration of the main loop. But before starting to talk about the second improvement, I just want to give you an overview about the SHA function. I think that everyone knows this function, but just to give you an idea of how it works, this hash function takes an input message, and then it happens appending and decides of the original message. And it obtains a final message that is a multiple of 64 bytes. Then for each then it split, the function split this message into an input block of 64 bytes. And then for each of those input block, the function computes the so-called W blocks, that are 64 W blocks, in which the first 16 relies directly on the values of the input block. Finally, having those W blocks, the SHA function executes 64 rounds and then compute the current hash for the current input block. So having this information, going back to our algorithm, this is the input structure that BitCracker must hash during each iteration. Okay, looking at the first part, we can do nothing because the values of the previous hash and the first hash fields directly depends on the value of the input hash. So here we can do nothing, any type of prevision. But looking at the second part, we can do something because the second part of the structure, as I said, is composed by the salt that is fixed for each memory unit. So while BitCracker is attacking an encrypted memory unit, the salt will be always the same. So we can consider this value fixed during the attack. Then there's the counter, that is the number of the iteration. So we know at each iteration the value of the counter. Then to be compliant with the standard of the SHA function, there's the padding, and finally the size. Particular, the size will be always 88 because the original message that BitCracker must hash is composed by the first 64 bytes and then the salt and the counter. So having this information, we can make a prevision about the values of the structure during each iteration, and those values doesn't rely directly on the value of the input password. So we can make a precomputation of the W blocks that will be used by BitCracker during the main loop, during each iteration of the main blocks of the main loop. So BitCracker, to save arithmetical operation during the decryption procedure, before starting the decryption procedure, makes a precomputation of the W blocks and store them on global memory, because we are talking of GPUs. Okay, this is the final algorithm of BitCracker. The latest version of the final version of BitCracker implement this decryption algorithm. And as you can see, now BitCracker creates a structure of only 64 bytes. And during the main loop, during each iteration, BitCracker applies the standard SHA function to the first 64 bytes, to the input structure. And then the second hash is quite different from the standard because now the hash, the function doesn't compute the W blocks, but it loads them from the global memory. This improvement saved a lot of arithmetic operation and made the computation very, very fast. Moreover, I use the texture memory to access those W blocks to take the advantage of the texture cache. Okay, I just want to give you an overview, just other details about the implementation of BitCracker. As I said, BitCracker implements the final version of the decryption algorithm improved, as we saw in the previous slides. And as I said, BitCracker is a mono GPU algorithm written in CUDA C. And okay, it's a mono GPU algorithm, but I've also implemented a distributed solution. So BitCracker can run on different hosts with different GPUs connected on a network. As I said, inside BitCracker, we can find a lot of CUDA optimization, a lot of optimization for the CUDA environment. I try to avoid the usage of local memory. I made the precomputation of the W blocks, as I explained. And finally, I took particular care on the throughput on the instruction I used, because I tried to use only three different types of instruction, that are the addition and bitwise and shift. According to the CUDA programming guide, the addition and bitwise operation are operation with an high throughput. But unfortunately, the shift instruction is the instruction is the most used instruction by the SHA function, but it is also the instruction with the lowest throughput. Those considerations are totally true if we consider the Kepler architecture, but if we consider the Maxwell architecture, that is the last one, the last architecture of the Nvidia GPUs, those considerations are not totally true. We cannot just count the number of instructions and know the throughput, because in the Maxwell architecture, there are a lot of optimization, like more addition or more bitwise instruction are merged in a single instruction. So it's not totally true. But okay, this is how BitCracker works. This is the help of BitCracker. And as you can see, BitCracker takes as input the image of the encrypted memory unit and a file with the input word list to perform its dictionary attack. Moreover, you can specify a lot of different parameters to customize the launch of the kernel inside the GPUs, like the number of GPU and the size of the grid, the number of password that each thread must evaluate, and so on. And this is how BitCracker works. As you can see here, I've encrypted a memory unit using Windows 8. I use, just to give you an example of how it works, a very small dictionary as input. So when BitCracker starts, it starts to extracting the data from the encrypted image. So it reads the salt. It is able to read the salt, the nonce, the encrypted value master key, and all the information needed by BitCracker to perform the attack. Then it starts the precomputation of the W blocks. Then it stores them on the global memory. And finally, it starts the real attack. And if the password was in the input dictionary, BitCracker printed the right password. And here the password is Paperino, that means Donald in Italiano. This is the execution. Okay, I just want to give you an overview about the performance of BitCracker. As you can see, I made a lot of tests using different type of GPU and different type of architecture. And I choose two different type of metrics to evaluate the performance of BitCracker. The first one is the number of passwords that BitCracker is able to evaluate at each second, per second. And the second one is the number of hash, of SHA-256 hash function that BitCracker is able to perform per second. As you can see, obviously, the most interesting result is the one with the Titanics, that is one of the latest GPUs released by NVIDIA. And it works with the Maxwell architecture. And BitCracker is able to perform about 1.8, 1.9 gigahash per second. Okay, that's a great result, but I just want to give you an idea, making some comparison with the other famous password cracker, like hashcat and John the Ripper. I use the GPU version of Hashcat engine, the Reaper. And okay, it's not a totally fair comparison because for each of those tools I used, I tried to make the test as fast as possible. So they are not doing exactly the same thing. The tests with Hashcat are totally in line with the benchmark they published on their site, in the case of the Rosha format. And the John the Ripper team helped me to make the test with HMAC SHA to get the number of the SHA performed per second. Moreover, it's not totally fair because the half of the hash applied by BitCracker have the WBlocks improvement that can be applied only in the BitLocker situation, so it cannot be used in any in the standard SHA application of this function. It's just to give an idea. Okay, this is just a resume. So what I've done, CUDA C algorithm, fully optimized for the CUDA environment. And as I said, I've implemented also the distributed solution of BitCracker. And I have no restriction, BitCracker has no restriction about the type or architecture of Nvidia GPUs. That is, if you change the GPU, there are some differences in performance, but the final result doesn't change. So. But there are a lot of bad things, a lot of improvements that can be done on BitCracker. In fact, BitCracker is able to work only on a dictionary attack, and it's not able to perform a mask mod attack, so it is not able to generate a word list. It only read the input word list without any smart reading. Moreover, you can use BitCracker only on NVIDIA GPUs because there is not an OpenCL version. And as you saw, there is not a graphical interface for BitCracker. And it's a good thing. I'm writing a paper about my research. That's all. Thank you.